is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my bed.
It's so good to see all of you as we gather together once again for our Wednesday night Bible studies. Tonight I am so excited to be able to share with you more about the Word of God as we look at the topic of the law of lasting value. Zig Ziglar once said, "Don't count the things you do, but do the things that count." Years ago, I began understanding the law of lasting value as I began looking at the things that were most valuable to me in my life. There are things that I hold very valuable still today that some people might not think hold much value at all, but they're little things. I still have a little pipe that my grandfather used to smoke when he was in his younger days. And it was one of the last things that I have of my grandfather. And I have it in a special case, and I keep it nearby because it reminds me of the kind of man that he was. It's silly, I understand, to some people that a pipe would be symbolic, that it would be symbolic of a great man, a great man of God, a man of character, a man of honor and integrity. But that pipe holds great value to me. It's lasting value. Early on, I really began to understand the law of lasting value, that it's not always about the amount of money something is worth, but it truly is about its great value. And so never underestimate the law of lasting value. The law of lasting value is really, it's influenced by your priorities. And what we understand is that your priorities today, they shape your principles tomorrow, which in turn ultimately shape a lasting legacy, a legacy that is of lasting value. One of the most successful basketball coaches in all of sports history was a man by the name of John Wooden. And during the year of 1948, he began coaching the UCLA Bruins. And he built a basketball program that would eventually lead to 10 national championships in 12 years and 4 undefeated seasons. What made Wooden such an amazing coach really wasn't his stunning win-loss record. What made him such an amazing coach was that he understood the law of lasting value. And he invested into his athletes, into his kids, more than just basketball principles and fundamentals. But he invested into these athletes lasting values. He once said that ability may get you to the top, but it takes character to keep you there. And so, I want us to begin thinking about the law of lasting values and to understand how that little simple principle can compel us to accomplish and do great things, not only in this life, but also to impact the generations that follow us even many, many years from now, even many years after we take our last breath. Now, there are 3 basic fundamentals of the law of lasting values that I want you to really begin wrapping your mind around today. The very first fundamental is to see, or otherwise to make sure that you see the investment opportunities that you have around you each and every day. Applying this law of lasting value, it means that you are going to choose to be very intentional. Very intentional about choosing what and how you spend your time every day. There are certain things, if you're like me, that you understand that you really need to spend more time on. And there are also certain things that you realize that you need to spend more time avoiding. Every individual has 1,440 minutes in every single day. And so the question is, why are some people more successful at utilizing 1,440 minutes than others? I mean, what makes the big difference? Well, the big difference is really made by understanding that of lasting value, of taking the minute that you have, the hour that you have, and making sure that you utilize it to make a lasting impact. Nobody gets more time than that any day. And so the question ultimately is, how do we take the time that we've been given, the opportunity we've been given, and use it to the best of our ability? In Ephesians chapter 5, verses 15 through 16, it says, "Pay careful attention then to how you walk, not as unwise, but as wise, and make the most of the time that you have." Now, we're going to come back to that passage of Scripture here in just a little while. But that passage reminds us that we, you and me, and those around us, that we need to be very careful, and we need to pay careful attention to how we choose to live our life, how we choose to spend our time, and what we spend our time on, what we spend our time avoiding. So I'm going to begin thinking here today about what it is that you could spend more time on in the remainder of this day, the remainder of this week, that you could spend more time on that will have a lasting impact and lasting value versus spending time on the things that come here one moment and are gone the next. So, see the opportunities around you each and every day. And when you do that, you will begin practicing the law of lasting value in a great and amazing way. Now, the second stage, the second step in the law of lasting value is to seize the time that you've been given, the moment you've been given, and to be wise in how you spend that time. You have 24 hours in every single day, and you will have many different requests upon your time. There will be many things that will come to you every day that will demand your time. And with the use of time, there will come the use of energy. There will come the use of your focus. But there are always going to be three different types of individuals that come into your life every single day. And I want you to remember this. I want you to understand that every day there will be people that come into your life that are either, number one, an encourager, number two, a diminisher, or number three, a drainer. And the great question ultimately is, who are you surrounding yourself more with each and every day? Are you surrounding yourself more with those encouragers? Or are you surrounding yourself with the diminishers? Or are you being completely derailed? Are you being bombarded day after day by those that are the drainers? Now, the encourager, that's the individual that comes alongside of you. They have a desire to build you up and to do everything that they can to equip you with the right tools to help you accomplish great and amazing things. But then there are also the diminishers, the people that come into your life, and really one of their main objectives is to be negative, to tear down what you have done and to tear down what you've accomplished. These are the individuals that often will point out your failures on a regular basis. They have a tendency to point out your weaknesses and the missed opportunities that have led to failure in your life. And then there's the drainer, the individual that consumes large amounts of your time, large amounts of your emotional energy, leaving you fatigued at the end of the day and wore out emotionally and even physically. Now, understand that as people come in and they demand your time, as they require your time, your energy, they will be in one of those three categories. And so what do? Well, the good news is that you're in charge of how you invest your time, how you seize the moment that you have, the day that you have, and how you interact with the people around you, who you interact with. And so first, make sure that you choose to be on your guard. Be on your guard against those who tear you down. Be on your guard and limit your time with the diminishers and the drainers that come into your life. And in so doing, you will accomplish more for the Lord with less time and less energy. Yes, you'll accomplish more. more for God's glory. Now, the other thing that you need to do is not only guard your time and guard your heart, guard your mind, guard your life against those who seek to drain and diminish you, but you also need to make sure you're maximizing your time, that you're maximizing the opportunities with encouragers every single day. Make it a regular habit to get in touch with one person that is an encourager and let them pour into you, even if it's only for a minute. There's a man that I have a tendency to call about every other day, or he calls me. And it's one of those give-and-take relationships where, yes, we'll talk about what's going on in our lives and what's going on in the day, but we always make sure that we encourage one another. And I wonder, do you have someone in your life like that, that you can encourage them and they can encourage you? And that you make it a regular habit, if not every day, every other day, of just contacting each other and being there for one another. In 1 Thessalonians 5:11, the Apostle Paul points out, therefore encourage one another and build one another up just as you're doing. It's the law of lasting value. The final stage, the final step in the law of lasting value is not only are you to see the opportunities that you have around you, to seize the moments that you have, but you are also to make sure that you soar, that you take all that you have learned, all that you understand, all that you've gained, that you put it into practice. And so each day, no matter what the distractions come that threaten to derail your life, no matter what disruption comes to unsettle your life emotionally and even spiritually, make sure you seek the presence of the Lord. Renew your heart and renew your mind in His Word. And when you do that, He will give you wisdom, and He will help you make the wise decisions that you need to make, to arm you with discernment, and to be able to correctly identify the will of God in every circumstance that you face. Remember what we read earlier in Ephesians 5:16, that you need to make the most of the time that you've been given. The reason why is the days are evil, or otherwise the days are distracting. The days will bring many things that will come to try to derail you from God's purpose, God's word, and God's way. And so every day, make sure that you follow the advice given to us in Romans 12, verse 2. It's that passage that you've heard maybe before. Maybe you're familiar with it. It says, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed. Be transformed by the renewal of your mind, so that by the testing, you may discern what the will of God is, what is good and acceptable and perfect. And so, I wonder today, how will you look at the time you have, the time that you have the remainder of this day, the opportunities you have the remainder of this day, the interactions that you have with friends and family and loved ones? How will you look at those differently as you go through the remainder of this day and the remainder of this week? Make sure that you take the time you've been given, the opportunities you've been given, and give them lasting value by learning to see, to seize, and to soar. And so today, make an eternal impact and begin applying the law of lasting value. Let's pray. Dear Father God, we thank you for this day. And we pray that you would give us wisdom and discernment, open our eyes, our hearts, our minds, and help us live in such a way that our time and our actions have lasting value. May you forever be glorified. In Jesus' name we pray, and all God's people say,